nice to be back in San Francisco and out of my hometown, which is pretty hot these days. It's really nice to see my neighbor go to jail on network television yesterday. A little disturbance down in Key West. I have to stay out for a while. It's good for my health. We're on the road. That's weird, man. Sitting there eating a cheeseburger, and there's my house. Taking my neighbor to jail.
Possession of cocaine.
I didn't know what he did for a living. I knew he drew a big, had a big car, and he ate well. Always told him to carry a lot of grocery bags in. I didn't know. I don't know anything. I never want to know anything. Damn. I washed my hair with that peach shampoo. I smell like a sundae. I did. Ran out of stuff. Used fingers. Rock and roll shampoo back there. Here's a little. Let's do a little thing called Great Filling Station Holdup. We're going to do there. His finger. I had a severe accident. A trimmer down in L.A., a table leaped up and hit me in the finger.
$15 and a can of STP. Big old jar of cashew nuts and a Japanese TV. Feeling we had for the biggest heist of our career. We're wanted men, we'll strike again. First, let's grab a beer. Now I wish I was somewhere other than here. Down in some honky tonk. Wish I was somewhere other than here. Because that great filling station, hold up, well, it cost me two good years.
Truck broke down. We had 15-foot Felix cymbals and a lot of dry ice and costumes. But it's budget cuts these days, you know.
I really miss the elephant.
running on two pairs of Adidas or Harley. One for the East Coast, one for the West. Blue and green. This is a little thing that Roger wrote, a song. We've been on a whirlwind blitz tour through Texas, and we drove out here on a bus. First time I've been on the bus and saw cactuses and stuff out in the desert and ran into ginseng weed and things like that. Had lots of blowouts and there were no tires either. Sitting out there. I didn't know Arizona was there. Yeah. Yuma. I've been to Yuma, you know. Capaya. It's been a western. It was there. Big truck stops and everything. A little thing called Dallas that we'll do for you right now. Trying to get this new album together. It's going to be out probably before the next birth of our Lord, and if everything goes right, or Christmas Day, be a nice thing to send for Christmas present. We're going to. I tried to get a whole new marketing approach to it. I figured we That's fun dealing with record companies. It really is. I said, well, let's just make 25 albums and sell them for $32,000 a piece. First come, first serve, you know? Everybody gets a Vegematic, first 10 albums, you know? They didn't buy that. Well, they wouldn't. So we're going to have to revert to things like songs and instruments and make a real record, I guess. This will be our token trash song. It seems to be getting that way. I can't help but write them because they, you know, I involve myself in certain situations sometimes. This is called Please Take Your Drunken 15-Year-Old Girlfriend Home. I think the title speaks for itself. It's but it's hot. I mean, we've come a long way here now. We're opening for like big groups and things, and so you're into teen appeal, which has never been a problem with us before, because people never knew who the hell Jimmy Buffett and the Coral Reefer Band was. And they were an opening act, but now about some of them do, and I wish they didn't, because it's real weird, because when I was that age, I was in Catholic school, and they stuffed everything under starch and uniforms, and now it's just out there, and there's... In the South, there's big boyfriends with all girlfriends because they aren't there alone. It's date night most places, and you get a little drunk. Hello there, honey. Come on down. Fingers does it all the time. Yeah, I try to stop them all. You know? Trying to reprieve these boys from their dirty image. Apparently, it'll never do any good, you know. We get criticized for writing songs about drugs and sex and booze, but sorry, that's the ballpark I play in. And we've turned down the Vegas circuit many times before. We're hot in Vegas, we really are. Hot in Key West too right now, yeah.
She shouldn't be back here.
Marvin Gardens is barely alive. He's in a rest home in Sarasota. Couldn't take this road much longer. We sent him down there. Has a little IV unit with Gatorade in it. He's doing all right, I guess. Let's do this. A little thing called Life is Just a Tire Swing.
Crazy old uncle and aunt lived in a big house, antebellum style, and the wind would blow across the old bayou, and I was a tranquil little child. Life is just a tire swing. Jumping, lie still, the only song I can sing. Blackberry picking, eating fried chicken, and I never knew a thing about pain.
Mustache? Oh, I thought that was the name of the city.
We'll do Come Oakland for you.
Never mind, we're just a little batty up here. It really throws me every time I see a Star Trek I've never seen before. It blows my whole day. Saw one today, I'd never seen that one. At the acting company, the guy was an old massacred ship that Captain Kirk was on. I'd never seen that one. It's real tricky. It's on 74 of them now. I wanted to call his new album Beamus aboard Scotty. And, oh, Mr. Scott, I'm giving you all I can, Captain. Scott damn Indians won't go any faster. Love that show, man. I really do. but this is called Trying to Reason with Hurricane Season, and that intro had nothing to do with the song. Just that it is storm season down there now, and only if you're going to get blown away, it's more fun to be blown away while you're doing it. That's why everybody stocks up for storms. They're a lot of fun.
All right, a little traveling music, please.
Falls out on the Gulf Stream. Big storm is coming soon. I passed out in my hammock. Gotta sleep till way past noon. Stood up and tried to focus. I hoped I wouldn't have to move on. Sure could use a bloody mirror. So we stumbled next door to the bar. And now I must confess, I can use some rest.
Tricking with my bad finger here. Chet Atkins licks. It's a little thing about mortal sin. Ha ha ha. I'm trying to rapidly control these things. It's called Grapefruit Juicyfruit. And, chew a little. Sparkle. Oh, my God. They're landing. Beam me aboard. Oh, go ahead. Very well, Lieutenant Uhura. Yeah. they got green bottoms. Will that do? Yeah, I guess that'll have to do, as far as it's concerned. This goes out for my Orange County loves, guys. Needs a penny. Well, thank God. Wish I had a pencil-thin mustache.
Pencil.
mustache, then I can solve some mysteries too.
Saxophone player tonight. We're gonna bring up Peter from nearby stand. Where'd he go? Yeah, Peter, right there. All right. Yes. It's a real thrill. It's not even a saxophone. It's a little cassette in there. That cues up.
God.
Get the cake. Good God, Roger. Watch out.
Thomas and Frogman Henry used to boogie woogie all night long. Oh, I love rock and roll. The acoustic guitar was the only chance I had of becoming a star. Doing rather nice and traveling around, but they won't play my record in my old hometown. If we had saxophone, big baritones cleaning up the muddy. Missing from them good old songs. But here we had saxophone, big parrot.
you, Peter, for that. All right. Yes. It's contestant number one. All right. Excellent. Like to do. Oh, that's fun, man. I've always wanted that to be right there when I won. No hard feelings, Harry. No. Just pack up your bags, get your little lunch box. Harry usually takes that break, see? Used to take that break. You can have it back tomorrow, I swear I'll give it back to you. Okay. Oh. We're gonna do, we're gonna treat you. This is a real special treat. This is a new song called Havana Daydreamin'. Hot off of the press here. I stole this from somewhere, I'm sure, but dedicated to all of my friends, the fire chief and city attorney, who are now out of jail. We had a little shakeup in our organization down there. I love the, this is verbatim from the NBC guy who was on. He said that cocaine was as easy to buy as key lime pie in Key West. Oh, boy. Not going home today, no sir. Go up east for a while.
Hand out a dog.
Thank you.
daydreaming. Boy, he's just scheming his life away.
Song about a traveling salesman in Nebraska, by the way. Yeah, you buy that one, I will too. This is a little thing Stevie Goodman and I wrote about one of your California culture heroes. Monty, Monty, Monty. Carol Merrill. Carol Merrill let her hair grow long, man. Wearing two-piece outfits. Getting heavy there. Maybe she'll come see us at the Palomino. Oh, heartthrob, heartthrob. Introduce and reintroduce A1A, you. A1A B12. I want to introduce you to the band now, the fantabulous Coral Reefer Band. What's their names again? Oh, over on the left, on guitar, Mr. Roger Bartlett over there. On the harmonica and the piano and the Dos Equis, Mr. Fingers Taylor over there. On the bass, it sounded damn near like a saxophone, Harry Daly. Our own little taco back there, Mr. Philip Ajardo on the drums. This is a song Fingers wrote. It's a thing to get him to write a song. I had to take him to beautiful New England where it rained for 8 days and locked him in a cottage. And he came out with this little gem here. It's called Big Rig. We're going to do it. Home rolling with you than watching Tom Snyder on TV. I wish I was a big rig rolling on home to you. I wish I was a big rig. Big rig, baby, rolling on home to you. I've been to lots of parties. Big rig, baby, rolling on home to you.
rock and roll there.
Yes, we're gonna do a pirate looks at 40. A1AB1. It's getting weird toward the end here. We've been in the Midwest for a little while, and people would request songs right after we did them. I got real strange. I couldn't figure it out. So, time delayed soap opera, I guess. I don't know. I know they don't. They don't understand there. I mean, the Midwest is there just to keep California and New York apart. Because everybody, heart of America. People that brought you granola.
We have a radio show going on in the amplifier over there, buddy.
Turn it up. What's on?
Well, that's it.
You recorded it, man.
I can't. Well, we got the CBS Mystery Radio on Roger's amp up here.
What?
What did you say?
She said filthy words.
They were talking dirty on your amp. Y'all didn't hear that. We're picking up a radio station on the amp. Weird night. Wait a minute. Well, there's always something happening in San Francisco. Mother, Mother Ocean, I have heard you call. I wanted to sail upon your waters since I was 3 feet tall. You've seen it all. You've seen it all. Watch the man who rode you switch from sails to steam. In your belly you can hold the treasures you have ever seen. Most of them dream. Most of them dream. Yes, I am a pirate, 200 years too late. Cannons don't thunder, there's nothing to plunder. I'm an over 40 victim of fate. Arriving too late. Arriving too late. I've done a bit of smuggling. I've run my share of grass. I made enough money to buy Miami, but I pissed it away so fast. It's never meant to last. Never meant to last. I have been drunk now for over 2 weeks. I passed out and I rallied and I sprung a few leaks. But I got to stop wishing, got to go fishing. I'm down to rock. Just a few friends. Several a while, and though I ran them away, they'd come back one day and they still could manage to smile.
takes a while. Just takes a while. Mother, mother ocean, after all my years I've found my occupational hazard being my occupation's just not around. I feel like I've drowned, but I won't wear a frown. I feel like I've drowned. Gonna get drunk uptown.
Nice to be able to do that. We don't get to do all those with the boogie crowd, you know. All right. We're going to feature our little choreography department here before we run off. You ready there, kiddo? This is going out on the radio, so for too bad all you radio people are missing this, this dance that's about to occur. This is the... Sausalito Rain Dance is performed by Roger Bartlett up here to the tune of They Don't Dance Like Carmen No More. I'm going to explain this. I'll give him a blow-by-blow description of these dances. Roger's now clasping his hands together. Modest prayer there. He's works in airports on weekends selling books for Hare Krishna. Ready? Gotcha. Walking down New Street, music is loud. Neon signs bring in tumultuous crowd. I'm just an old man, I'd probably get sold. But they don't dance like Carmen no more. Yeah, now she and old Coogan, my, what a pair. Doing the rumba as no one else dare. Sliding and gliding across Hollywood floor. But they don't dance like Carmen no more. Well now, she had a big hat. God, it was high. Had bananas and mangoes and wonton soup to the sky, how she could balance it, well, I wouldn't dare. But they don't dance like Carmen no way. Ah, but lady's not with us, she died long ago, and they don't run her movies on late midnight shows. Cause the kids, they get restless, and the grown-ups would snore. But they don't dance like Carmen no more. Yeah, now she and old Kuge, my, what a pair. Doing the boogie is no one else there. Baby sliding. They don't dance like Carmen no more. No, they don't dance like Carmen no more. I'm
just an old man, I'd probably get sore. But they don't dance like Carmen no more. Now they don't dance like Carmen no more. Yeah, 10 cents a dance, oh, I might take a chance. But they don't dance like Carmen no more.
We're gonna do another new thing. While you're here, as the band keeps progressing, finish out our little first set with this. And it's a little thing called Kick It In Second Wind, or How I Spent My Last Option at the Troubadour. Coughing over there? Ready to go? Huh?
I'm ready.
Again, a nice hand, please, for the Choral Reaper Band up here. And to Peter for jamming on saxophones, and for Mick Jagger and Joe Cocker and everybody for stopping by. It was really a pleasure.
It really was. Thanks, boys.
Got to do another show. Oh, in the band. All right. Johnny Buffett.
Jimmy Buffett, live from the boarding house, brought to you tonight by ABC Dunhill Records.
It's gonna be a pleasant 3 days, no doubt about it. So I'm gonna do, let me just fix this.
You're not gonna be here for the weekend.
What day is today?
Don't worry about it,
guys. I don't care. Let me do that. We're gonna do a. Can you hear this all right? Can you hear this? Because this guitar is acting up tonight. It's, I don't know. We're going to do this. That's what I'm going to do for you right here. Clear my ears. Boo! Oh, no. This is a song I'm dearly about to. We've never worked up in the Northwest very much before, up around Oregon and Washington. We went up there, and boy, Portland is like wino capital of the world. There's no doubt about it, man. Downtown Portland is a very strange place, and it's like it hadn't changed very much in the last 100 years or so. But not great people that live in the suburbs, man. I've never been to suburbs like that. But I got into it with a couple of winos again up there, and that's confirm my conviction that they're just sort of out there, you know. They could have, if you put all of that energy to use that they used to manipulate themselves to get to $3.50 a day to support their habits and put that to practical use, we could beat the fuck out of Standard Oil. Oh, I'm on the radio. We could sort of put those gentlemen on their dusters. Thank you. All right. This is a song I wrote about an old man still down in Grand Isle, Louisiana, named Jesse Bartholomew. It's called He Went to Paris. It's just a... It's an example of how you have to go out swinging, man. That's the only way to do it. He went to Paris looking for answers to questions that bothered him so. He was impressive, young and aggressive, saving the world on his own. But the warm summer breezes, the French wines and cheeses put his ambitions at bay. Summers and winters scattered like splinters, and 4 or 5 years slipped away. He went to England, played the piano, married an actress named Kim. They had a fine life, she was a good wife, and bore him a young son named Jim. And all of the answers and all of the questions he locked in his attic one day. He likes the quiet, clean country living, and 20 more years slipped away. Well, the war
took his baby. Bombs killed his lady and left him with only one eye. His body was battered, his whole world was shattered, and all he could do was just cry. While the tears were falling, he was recalling answers he never found. So he hopped on a freighter, skidded the ocean, and left England without a sound. Now he lives in the islands, fishes the pilings, and drinks his green label each day, writing his memoir, losing his hearing, but he don't care what most people say. 'Cause through 86 years of perpetual motion, if he likes you, he'll smile, then he'll say, Jimmy, some of it's magic, some of it's tragic, but I had a good life all the way. He went to Paris looking for answers to questions that bothered him so.